Hi, my name is Jennifer Hoskovec, and I'm Director of the Prenatal Genetic Counseling Services at McGovern Medical School at the University of Texas Health Science Center at Houston. Our genetic counselors work as part of a care team together with maternal-fetal medicine specialists, OBGYNs, gynecologic oncologists, and ultrasonographers to provide compassionate, comprehensive care for women. Genetic counselors provide information and support to couples interested in genetic screening and individuals who may be at increased risk for genetic conditions based on their personal and family health histories. Pregnancy is a very exciting time for couples, but we know that many women also have questions, particularly when considering their options for genetic screening. There are multiple genetic screens available during pregnancy, and a conversation with a genetic counselor can help women understand these screening options and provide them with the knowledge they need to make the choice that is best for them and their family.
Carrier screening is offered to every couple, regardless of their family history, to help determine you and or your partner's chance to be a carrier of specific genetic conditions, including cystic fibrosis. The results of carrier screening are used by a doctor or a genetic counselor to help determine your specific risk to have a child with certain genetic conditions.
Hello, my name is Artie, and I'm one of the genetic counselors at McGovern Medical School at UTHealth. First trimester screening is one of several different prenatal testing options available to women who would like to learn more about the chances of their pregnancy having various chromosome conditions, such as Down syndrome. This test is routinely offered to all pregnant women and can be performed between the beginning of the 11th week of pregnancy to the end of the 13th week. In addition to Down syndrome, it also screens for other rare chromosome conditions called trisomy 13 and trisomy 18. First trimester screening does not provide a yes or no answer about these conditions, but instead provides an individualized risk assessment, given a couple ultrasound measurements and blood work.
I can tell you a little bit more about this new screening test called non-invasive prenatal testing, otherwise known as NIPT. NIPT is a new screening test that can be performed on a blood sample anytime after 9 to 10 weeks of pregnancy. NIPT is different than other screening tests because it analyzes genetic information from the pregnancy, something we call cell-free DNA, that enters mom's bloodstream through the baby's placenta. Well, this is very exciting because it can tell us whether the baby is going to be a boy or a girl. This test is designed to look for genetic conditions such as Down syndrome. It can also look for other conditions that are more or less severe than Down syndrome, so it's important to talk with your doctor or genetic counselor about the conditions that will be included in your screening panel.
My name is Leslie Dunnington, and I am a cancer genetic counselor. My job is to work with patients and their families in helping them to understand their history of cancer and how to manage their cancer risk. Only a small portion of cancers are hereditary, meaning that certain types of cancer can run in a family. Most cancer occurs due to chance or to a combination of risk factors such as age and environmental exposures.
We hope the information we have provided to you today is helpful when considering your options for genetic screening. We encourage you to discuss your questions with your doctor and consider genetic counseling if additional support and information may be of help to you and your family.